Thank you, respected chairpersons, and good afternoon, everybody. And thank you for inviting me once to Myanmar. I had promised Tinswelard that I will come wearing a lungi this time. But today, sir gave me a new tie. So this is my tie. And I'm very proud to be part of MMDA. So thank you for having me here. We face many challenges in the developing world. And like you have seen from speakers, we had Professor Basit speaking from Pakistan. You find that the challenges are the same all across the developing world. But when we speak of challenges, that's not enough. We also have to speak of solutions. So you must have seen Dr. Basit talking about solutions. And you've seen our respected speakers from Japan and from Taiwan talking about solutions as well. And when we see senior members of the house, like revered sir, we find that the solutions that you are giving us are very simple, very basic. The point is that we have to walk the talk. We have to follow those solutions. The same holds true for insulin. So today, let's talk about some issues with insulin therapy. Many times we have seen at international platforms that people from developing countries keep on talking about challenges, they keep on talking about problems, they talk about financial issues. But we forget that we have a very rich culture and we have many things that help us in our career, they help us in our journey where we are trying to become good doctors and we are trying to help our country women and countrymen. This balance that we have between culture and between the challenges of modern medicine, this is what we'll try to explore today. Finding a balance is not a new challenge. This was faced by Lord Buddha as well. And what he tries to teach us is that we have to find the middle path. And forgive me if my Burmese is wrong, but that's ale alat. That's, you always have to try and find the middle path. That's what we'll try to do in this talk. When we try to find the middle path in diabetes, there is a middle path that the person with diabetes has to tread. Calories and tasty food on one hand, biomedical issues and psychological or psychosocial concerns on the other hand, efficacy of insulin on one hand, safety and tolerability on the other hand. But for most of these problems, the solution either now or a few years later is going to be insulin. So in today's talk, we'll talk about five M's that matter. And since we have just half an hour, we'll note that you all have handouts and you will find some articles in your bags that you have. Please feel free to go through them at leisure and please feel free to contact us later on if you have any issues. The five M's of insulin therapy that we count are, number one, you have to match the insulin to the patient. So every patient needs the correct insulin. It is not vice versa. Second is that it is not just enough to prescribe the correct insulin. We also have to motivate the patient. So we have to converse with, we have to talk to, we have to explain the patient about why he or she needs insulin. That also is not enough because we also have to teach the patient how to take insulin. So the third M is the method of insulin delivery. There are two more M's as well. It is not enough just to prescribe the correct insulin, to motivate the patient to take insulin, and to teach the correct insulin delivery method. You also have to monitor therapy. So we'll talk about the fourth M as well, and we'll talk about how to monitor therapy in a resource challenge setting. And the fifth M is to be ever vigilant and to be dynamic, because diabetes is a very dynamic disease. And if we have to defeat diabetes, we have to be more dynamic than the syndrome itself. So we have to be prepared to modify our dose, our insulin preparation, and our insulin regime if required. We'll talk about all these M's one by one. You will find that we will intersperse motivation throughout the talk. Our main focus, however, will be matching insulin to the correct, to the patient. We will also, like I said, intersperse with motivational interviewing. We will spend just a few minutes on insulin technique at the end, and we'll also talk about insulin monitoring and some clinical methods of monitoring therapy. And during our discussion on how to choose the correct insulin, we will also talk about modification of insulin regimes. So the first M is to match insulin to the patient. Any idea who this person is? A very famous person. In Hindi, in India, his name is Anirudh. In Myanmar, he is known as the builder of the nation, Anahata. He was a master strategist, and he knew what to do and how to do it. Basically, what we learned from him is, first of all, you have to define a target. So, what is our target in diabetes care? Once you have defined the target, then you plan a strategy. Once you have planned the strategy, only then do you pick your tools or you decide how to do it. When I was a junior, and even now, we face challenges. There are so many oral drugs available in the market. There are so many insulins available in the market. All these are tools. If we were to go by the textbook, we have so many tools available to us. But these tools are of no value if we do not have a strategy to use them with. And this strategy will be of no value if we do not know where we are going.
CFirm, caring for well-being.